I'm Hayley Nelson. I'm a graduate student in the plant pathology department at Iowa State University. My graduate research focuses on improving and modifying a system to control bacterial wilt disease in organic muskmelon and squash. Bacterial wilt is a disease that affects predominantly the eastern half of the United States in cucurbit crops. Cucurbits are plants such as muskmelon, squash, pumpkin, and cucumber. What happens is cucumber beetles, spotted and striped cucumber beetles, carry a bacteria in their gut, and they emerge from the soil in the spring and begin feeding voraciously on cucurbit plants. And as they feed, they spread this bacterium. The bacterium enters the xylem of these plants, and this bacteria multiplies. It's really happy inside these plants, and it sort of gums up the xylem. So this reduces water flow and is what leads to the plants wilting and eventually dying. So for my research, we're testing some new materials. One is we're using a different support structure for a row cover fabric. It consists of 10-foot electrical conduit pipes, and so we've bent those using a hoop bender. And we're hoping they'll be a little stronger, sturdier, last for a lot more seasons than a traditional wire hoop system. And then we're also testing a new fabric. The new fabric is called ProtecNet. It's a fine insect netting that's small. The holes are small enough that they exclude cucumber beetles from accessing the plants and spreading this disease. In both systems, we're draping this insect netting over the plants immediately after transplant, and we're doing this on muskmelon and squash plants. So you drape that over the plants at transplant, and in one system, when we begin to see female flowers on the plants, we remove the row cover for 2 weeks. During that 2-week window, we're allowing for pollination. We're also applying insecticides to control cucumber beetles based on insect scouts. And then after that 2-week window, we reapply the row cover material to the plants and have control against cucumber beetles for the rest of the season until harvest. In our other system using the same materials, instead of removing the row cover for 2 weeks to allow for pollination, we're placing beehives underneath the row covers instead. So these beehives we order from Copert Biological as soon as we see female flowers on the plants. And then we place them under the row covers. We set them on a stack of bricks so that they're above the soil. They're not getting wet underneath. We also cover the hives with protective structures. We just use laundry baskets, and that helps to prevent wind and rain and storms from affecting them. So these hives are traditionally used in greenhouse systems where they're a lot more protected from the elements. But we found that they were well protected with the structures that we made, and they did well. We compared both of these new modified systems with the traditional agribund system as well as a non-covered control. And we found that the full season ProtecNet system, where we don't remove the row covers at all, actually resulted in twice the number of fruit that are actually marketable for a grower. So that was really promising, and that was compared to all other treatments. And then we found that both the modified systems actually had the same amount of bacterial wilt control, but they both did better than the traditional agribund system. And then we also found that the full season ProtecNet system required 0 insecticide sprays. So results for our first season were very promising, and we're still looking at the data for this second season that we just finished, and we'll also have a third season next year. Funding for this research was provided by the USDA NEFA Organic Transitions Program.